Wichita State lost four of their first six, but have won their last two to even their record at 4-4. Your officials for today's game, Randy Heimerman, Kip Kissinger, Jerry Pollard. We are underway, and Utah controls the opening tip.
Rich, right away, watch for number 42 in red, Jakob Poeltl, as he goes the block. They try to get him a touch nearly every single possession.
No secrets to each team's goals today. For Utah, get the ball to your big man. There he is on the pick and roll. Seven to shoot. Now five on the shot clock. Bonham launches from deep and knocks it down.
Where sometimes when your offense breaks down, it's good enough just to get it to Lorenzo Bonham and knock down the shot. That JUCO transfer keeps getting better, starting to get his game legs now underneath him at the Division I level.
Here's Evan Wessel, one of the winningest players in college basketball, number three in yellow. Van Vliet, the preseason All-America, his first shot of the game. Matching three-pointers to start off.
Over the seven-footer with his outstretched arms, Jakob Poeltl. I'm surprised that Van Vliet actually took the jump shot. I thought he might go after Poeltl and try to get a body bump to get the first foul on number 42 in red.
Well, that's what Greg Marshall told us. They are going to attack the rim today. Wichita State doesn't shoot it particularly well from the outside. Here's 11 in red. That's Brandon Taylor.
Good seal by Poeltl. He knows the angles of the game. Look at the switch off here. So Van Vliet matched up with Poeltl, decides to shoot over the outstretched arm of the seven-footer. Man, that was just feathery touch from deep over the big fella.
Such a difference maker. Maybe the most valuable player in all of college basketball, Fred Van Vliet.
Well, they were 2-4 without him. And there's a shot clock violation.
And that's why Utah tends to struggle when they play on the road. Conversely, that's why Wichita State is so successful at home, whether it's at Koch Arena on their campus or here at Intrust Arena.
And Larry Kristoyak came in with a game plan. Get the ball to Poeltl. First two possessions, he got one touch with the turnover. Near turnover.
Tied at three, nearly 2 minutes gone by in this rematch from a thriller of a game last year that Utah won in overtime by 1 point.
One of the best games of the season. I loved watching that game.
Wessel, shot fake, drive. Here's Morris underneath. Had a shot altered by the interior defense of the Utes.
Big mistake by Shaq Morris. He faded on that shot. You've got to attack the shot blocker and take it right to his chest.
Here's Bonham. He has the only field goal of the game for the running Utes. Good defense taken away by the Shockers. Zach Brown in transition. Cuts through the lane and the lefty layup is good.
All started with the deflection from Evan Wessel. Number three in gold. Defensively, he makes a difference. Doesn't make a difference on the offensive end. Only averages 3 points a game. But defense, he has great hands, great anticipation.
There's 21 in red. Jordan Loveridge. He is a star in the making. If you haven't seen him, he's pretty terrific. And so is that guy, Jakob Poeltl, his first two of the game.
That's a seven-footer from the three-point line with one dribble to the rim. I love the drop of the left shoulder and the leverage.
And Poeltl gets the rebound as well.
Love this big guy. Just watch 42 in red, how to play and how to improve.
Tied at five apiece.
The other matchup worth watching is Taylor and 11 versus Van Vliet in 23.
Repost by Poeltl. And he throws it away. That's the third Utah turnover in the first 3.5 minutes of this contest.
Watch Jakob Poeltl. Sets a little screen and then squares. Little inside pivot right there. Watch his left shoulder. Right there as he drops that shoulder to get leverage and blows right past Shaq Morris. That's a seven-footer doing that.
Something that I've seen from covering this Utah team a few times this season, how good his footwork is for a seven-footer. That jumps out at you.
He's got a little McHale in him, a little bit of Kevin McHale in him as far as his improving footwork.
Catch and fire, Baker, no, he's 0-for-2. And here comes Brandon Taylor. Big shoes to fill for him, trying to take over the point guard role from an All-American, DeLon Wright, one season ago.
Well, he's short of stature, but he's the guy that does need to score and start getting on pace offensively.
10 on the shot clock. Bonham, contested. Out of bounds, it'll be Wichita State basketball. We have our first timeout of the contest, and it's a tight one, as expected. Wichita State and Utah locked at 5.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance, and Vanda Pharmaceuticals, working to advance the development of new medicines.
This knotted at 5 in the early going here from Wichita, Kansas. We mentioned earlier that Wichita has a 35-game home win streak. Well, last year, Utah snapped Wichita State's 35-game regular season win streak, winning in Salt Lake City. They were led by DeLon Wright. Brandon Taylor, who's on the floor today for them, led all scorers with 17. Van Fleet sent the game to overtime. Baker gave the Shockers a lead on the road, but it was DeLon Wright who followed with a floater on the next possession, and Utah held on to win 69-68 in overtime. And Larry Krystowiak, his teams have just gotten better every single season he's been in Salt Lake City. Fifth season with the running Utes, went 26-9 a year ago and has four starters back from that team. So that 25 ranking next to their name, not a surprise.
He went from 6 wins to 15 wins to 21 wins to 26 wins in 4 consecutive seasons. That is getting it done in Salt Lake City.
Here's Van Fleet, blocked from behind by Loveridge. On the other sideline, it's Greg Marshall, his ninth season in Wichita, 18th overall. He has 402 career wins now, and he is the only coach to lead his team to 30 wins or more in each of the last 3 seasons. You could list any number of accolades for the Shockers, Mark, and he matches up with all the blue bloods. Wamakota almost traveled and got away with it. He gets the bucket.
After 17 seasons, Rich, Mike Krzyzewski had 370 wins. Boeheim had 411. Greg Marshall, nearly 400. 398 wins. That's how productive he's been against the legends of the game in 17 seasons.
Nice feed. Pirtle kicks it back out. Going late into the shot clock on virtually every possession for Utah. 3 to shoot. Taylor. Here's Bonham. Almost beat it, but missed the 3.
That's where Utah really misses DeLon Wright. We saw him make that late game shot. That's what he did late shot clock situations for Utah a season ago.
3 from Wessel. And that's a good sign for Wichita State if Evan Wessel is contributing on the offensive end.
Now, he hasn't shot it well. He's only shot 25% from 3 on the season. But if he starts making shots like that from the 4 spot, that's your stretch 4 for Wichita State.
Wichita State in early 2-for-4 from beyond distance, and that is a black mark for Utah. They do not defend the 3-point shot very well.
Now, Utah really struggles to defend the 3, 42.3% from behind the arc as we watch Ron Baker probe, and he finds one of his best friends in Evan Wessel.
And speaking of 3-pointers, Connor Francamp, number 33 in yellow, is checked into the game.
Yeah, from Wichita. So you've got Fred Van Vliet, Connor Francamp, and Ron Baker will take a blow now. But that's the luxury of bringing in the Kansas transfer, number 33 in gold. Keep an eye on his ability to knock down the tray.
Greg Marshall told us he is counting on him to hit his first 3-point attempt tonight. He was 0-for-5 in his Shockers debut against UNLV. 5 to shoot. Wessel does. Make it 2-for-2 from distance for Evan Wessel.
Evan Wessel, known for 4 burns, for taking the charge, for grabbing loose balls. If he starts making 3 from the 4 spot, he is a dangerous player.
An 8-0 Shocker run gives him an 8-point lead.
Well, the Wichita fans, they smell a little blood early, don't they?
Kuzma. Good position on the feed from Pirtle, and Kyle Kuzma will go to the line and shoot 2, a highly regarded sophomore out of Flint, Michigan.
Evan Wessel, he's one of those guys, shoots a little bit of a set shot, can extend to the 3 range, and we saw him do that late last season. This season, he hasn't shot it well early, But he's such a big key. I mean, you've already got two All-Americans in the backcourt with Baker and Van Vliet. You add Francamp to that mix who can drain a three ball. And now you add Wessel, they become really hard to guard.
Kuzma, 6'9", redshirt sophomore from out of Flint, Michigan. He was best friends with Iowa State point guard Monte Morris coming out of that same area. Javonte Hawkins also, who's scoring 19 points a game from Eastern Kentucky. How about those pickup games at the YMCA in Flint?
Well, that's why he's gotten so much better. He only averaged 3.3 points a season ago. Over 10 points per game. He's an improved passer and rebounder. I like his upside.
Step through. Van Vliet, no. Good defense by the Utes. Taylor, a little stop and go. Nice take by Brandon Taylor.
Boy, does he play at different speeds right there. Kind of slowed up, pulled it out, and then exploded to the basket. Brandon Taylor.
Corner three, no good from the freshman Marcus McDuffie. Snared away by Kuzma.
I like the way Kuzma's going after those defensive rebounds. With Pirtle on the bench, you need another guy to step up. Number 35 in red, Kyle Kuzma. Really athletic with two hands going up after him.
So far, no rest for Fred VanVleet. He's only about 75% with that hamstring injury. And VanVleet, the rebound, one of the better rebounding guards in the country.
Yeah, we've seen him go for a triple-double before. He's willing to rebound, even at his size.
Same spot. Different result this time. Wessel with the miss.
See how VanVleet found him, though? Knows he's hot, gave him another touch. Smart point guard play.
3-for-7 for the Shockers from deep. Nice step through Brakot Chapman with his first two of the game.
Yeah, Chapman, one of those rangy guys at 6'8", 204. Not very physical, but he's wiry and he can slither through defenders.
Another open three. McDuffie, this time he nails it.
Marcus McDuffie, 6'8", 185. He can see over defenders. Another guy that's got a nice shooting touch. You saw right there out of St. Anthony's High School. Bob Hurley, one of the most legendary high school coaches in the history of high school basketball.
Loveridge, no. Van Vliet, his second rebound. You a little surprised that Wichita State's settling for the three, especially with Pirtle out right now?
They're taking what the defense gives them. Watch the red jerseys. They're playing a lot of times inside that pack line. They're extending on Francamp. They're daring Evan Wessel to shoot the basketball.
Here's Francamp. One more. Wessel can't hit it.
With the extra passing, though, put a lot of pressure on the defense.
Taylor switching speeds again, and a traveling violation. Turnover number 5 for the running Utes.
We talked about Fred VanVleet. What about this other point guard? Brandon Taylor. Hello, goodbye. Number 11. I'm going to make my teammates a little bit better. Give it up inside, number 11. Brandon Taylor, you can play, son.
In Wichita, Kansas, the Shockers lead the 25th-ranked running Utes 16-11, 10:50 to go. And, Mark, they say if it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. That's what Greg Marshall's hoping right now, because they started the season in the top 10 in the AP poll. Then Fred VanVleet went out. Then his backup, Landry Shamet, went out. They lost 4 of their first 6 games. Then they end up losing Anton Grady, their starting big man in the center. Van Vliet coming back. They're expecting Grady to make a full recovery. Landry Shamet won't be back until February, but a healthy team for the Shockers is a top 25 team for the Shockers.
Yeah, injuries in November have affected Wichita State more than any other top team in the country. That's why they're 4-4 right now. But with Fred Van Vliet, they just knocked off a very good UNLV team on Wednesday night. I was impressed with their ability to just lock down, defend against a running UNLV team that only scored 50 points in that contest.
Now Van Vliet on the bench for the first time this contest. That means 33 in yellow, Connor Francamp running the show for the Shockers. Browner Nerger stepping on, number 20, setting the screen.
It's always interesting to watch the offensive flow of Wichita State without Van Vliet against this tough Utah defense.
Here's Zach Brown, number 1. 3 to shoot. Rashard Kelly does and launches a brick.
See how that offensive possession turned into a late shot clock, unorganized possession? That's the value of Van Vliet right there. Now, Connor Francamp will pick it up, but it's going to take some time.
Want to know why the Pac-12 has the number one RPI in the country right now? Games like this, as you see another miss from Utah, Pirtle grabs the rebound, but you also might have noticed that Oregon State is traveling to Kansas City to take on the Kansas Jayhawks.
And UCLA plays Gonzaga. Tony Parker, one of the best bigs in the country, that comes out of the West. There's some good mountain men across the West, some big dudes that can play in the Western United States.
We'll talk about that in a little bit. Under 10 to go in the first half. 5-point Shockers lead. Here's Baker. Ten to shoot for the Shockers.
Well, credit Utah's defense. They've just been stingy on the last two possessions.
Left hand, no. Hurdle goes down and Zach Brown goes on top of him. Make that Rashard Kelly who landed on top of him. Well, you talked about the mountain men of the West. There are some big dudes who have big game out
there.
And
you know how much I love these big dudes. There's Pirtle right there. Tarzewski of Arizona. Karnowski of Gonzaga. Mamadou Njai, the big 7'6" guy out of UC Irvine. They're really good. And Tony Parker, the big load for UCLA. Those are some mountain men across the United States in the Western U.S.
Fresh 30 for the Shockers. Baker, the preseason All-America, controls. Now they got a mismatch with Pirtle on him. Here's Frankamp's first three, and he missed it.
You wonder when it starts getting in his head a little bit, going 0-for-5 in the first game, when it starts becoming a mental thing for number 33 in gold.
And just like that, Fred VanVleet is up off Greg Marshall's bench, ready to check back in. Stolen away by Brown. Defense to offense. Seven Utah turnovers. Wichita State taking advantage. The whistle, and they'll go to the line. Brakot Chapman will shoot two.
Greg Marshall wants Zach Brown to fill a role. What's that role? Defend. Be the best athlete. Keep the game simple. Don't turn it over, but force turnovers. Zach Brown, that's what he can do for you.
Seven zip points off turnovers. That's a good stat for Wichita State. You mentioned filling a role. To Cale Cotton, if you follow the Shockers at all, best defender, one of the best defenders in the country last year, also the winningest Shocker of all time, he graduated. Zach Brown's not going to fill those shoes, but that's the role that Greg Marshall needs him to step into.
Well, he's certainly athletic enough to make plays. He's a little bit more rangy in some ways than Cotton. Once he continues to develop, only a sophomore, he'll turn into a great defender.
Two for two for Chapman. He has four. And the Wichita State lead is five, 8:44 to go. Shockers valuing the basketball. No turnovers in the first half for Wichita State.
See how this possession runs with VanVleet in the game.
Top of the key, Baker.
It's amazing how their offense flows better simply because he's on the floor. Good screen right there. Ron Baker comes off. That's where he shows that ability, like a Kirk Heinrich, for example, to come off the screens and make plays. Watch the screen inside. Ronald Nurger right, number 20, there. And Baker is wide open as the defender takes a bad route, and Nurger gets in the defender's way.
You gotta love what Greg Marshall said about Ron Baker earlier this season. He said, Ron Baker is our Leo DiCaprio. If we're making a movie, he's our star. Who on this team wants to step up and be a co-star with him? Everybody else is the best boy grip, the mailman in the background. I need someone else to step up and be a star. Well, now they have Fred VanVleet back, so it's more of a Batman and Robin type of movie.
No question. So who's Fred?
I'll leave that for you to decide. Back-to-back buckets from Baker. Largest lead of the game for Wichita State, under 8 minutes to go.
Well, now Utah has to know who their best player is. Credit the Wichita State defense for not allowing Pirtle to get a touch. 42's got to get it in his hands this possession.
Yeah, until then, we haven't mentioned his name much at all. Here's Loveridge. leads the Pac-12 in three-pointers per game. This time, he's aggressive to the hole and gets fouled. Timeout on the floor, 7:35 to go. Shockers in the lead.
Wichita State so unselfish when Baker's in the game. All of a sudden gets a slip pass down low on the back cut. Well done.
Hey, Sam, did you...
Doug Kazarian with a studio update over on ESPN at Rupp Arena. Arizona State already with 10 turnovers in the first half. Marcus Lee, the finish in transition, but it's a close one. Again, over on ESPN right now, back to Wichita.
Thanks, Doug, and that continues our conversation from earlier, Mark Adams. The Pac-12 not afraid to schedule tough in the non-conference.
Well, that's why they're the number one RPI conference in the country right now. They're not afraid to go on the road and play against good people. I respect that about the Pac-12.
Wichita State up by 10 right now and kind of having their way with Utah, and it's the defense that's been so impressive for the Shockers.
You know what's been really interesting about Wichita State's last three games now against St. Louis, the top two scorers for St. Louis at halftime had 0 points. UNLV, top two scorers on Wednesday night, had a total of 4 points. Right now, Loveridge and Pirtle combined for 2 points in the first half, now four with those free throws.
Cutting the head off the snake, as most coaches would say. And look at the disparity in field goals, just in field goal attempts.
Now, Wichita State with 20 field goal attempts. Utah with 9 here in the first half.
That's a foul away from the ball. It's going to go on Utah. Well, tonight, following the Heisman Trophy presentation on ESPN, we've got the next 30 for 30 film, Four Falls of Buffalo, the story of those great Buffalo Bills teams who appeared in four straight Super Bowls and lost them all. Four Falls of Buffalo right after the Heisman presentation tonight at 9:30 on ESPN.
Jim Kelly, one of my favorite quarterbacks of all time. Steve Tasker, one of those special teams guys.
Look at that up and under by Baker. And he's hot all of a sudden with 7 points.
Well, he's so good. You know, he came in too as a freshman. He could put the ball on the floor, make some plays, could definitely make the three. He's added that second level. That mid-range game has been so effective for Ron Baker.
7 straight points for Bake. Stolen away by Shaq Morris. Look at the big man run the floor, but he couldn't finish. Looked like he wanted to dunk it, just didn't have the ups to dunk it. And Pirtle at the other end.
Really good cut there by Pirtle. While Shaq Morris was concerned about a missed layup on one end, Pirtle made him pay on the offensive end.
And it was Pirtle who ran the length of the floor. He grabbed the rebound that led to that break.
That's why I like Pirtle so much. Man, he can really run.
Baker missed that one.
This is Utah's opportunity to get back in the flow. They look good on the last two offensive possessions. Let's get a redo on that.
Here's Pirtle, handoff, foul. Well, anytime you have a big man who can run 94 feet, that's a luxury.
And Pirtle has such good hands, too. He runs the floor well. He catches everything you throw to him. The big Austrian, I just love his ability to A, run, and then B, catch everything. You can teach him the rest, and you can see that it's all coming together with him with the footwork down the low block as well.
And he usually plays his best against the best competition. Had 32-11 against Temple, 26-13 and 5 blocks against BYU.
Outplayed Okafor in that Sweet 16 game in the NCAA tournament as well.
Stolen away by Van Vliet. That's 10 Utah turnovers. See if the Shockers can make him pay like they have so far. A wing three, yes.
Well, Kuzma really working hard against Evan Wessel, number 3 in gold and 35 in red. Watch that matchup.
Here's Loveridge. Still hasn't gotten a field goal in this contest. No whistle. Van Vliet can't take advantage. Out of bounds, and it's going to be Utah basketball. 5 minutes to go in the first half. Largest lead of the game for the Shocks. And now Rashard Kelly's going to check on for Wichita State. And we continue with that Pac-12 narrative. Not only do we have Florida, Michigan State coming up right after us, 6 Eastern on ESPN2, but then the nightcap, UCLA going on the road to take on Gonzaga, a place where, shockingly, the Arizona Wildcats went in there and upset the Gonzaga Bulldogs at the Kennel.
Now, Gonzaga has their own set of issues now from an injury standpoint, with Shemek Karnowski now out, will not play against Tony Parker. That would have been a great matchup. Yeah. I'd love to see those two big guys go after each other. Of course, there's this guy named Sabonis, is pretty good too for Gonzaga.
Taylor lost the handle. Oh, and Taylor got hit right in the face. And they're going to call traveling on it as well.
Well, that's tough. That's a tough call right there. Because obviously, he got glanced in the face right there. And that's a foul.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just a flat-out foul. And you can't blame Brandon Taylor for being a little bit upset, or Larry Krystkowiak as well. That was just a missed call.
Missed call or not, it's the 11th turnover for the Utes, and that's translated to a dozen points off those turnovers from Wichita State.
And so much for freedom of motion on that play.
And Larry Krystkowiak is giving Kip Kissinger an earful.
Well, it was the call on the opposite end, and then Ron Baker's cutting through. Bonham got into the freedom of motion on the cut through the paint, and they catch him.
Here's the lob inside. No Pirtle, and the Shockers can't take advantage.
Look at all the yellow jerseys. Look at all the gold jerseys get back defensively.
Taylor, nice answer after getting hit in the face the last time down.
That just shows toughness. He's got the heart of a lion. I love that little guy. He comes and competes.
Brandon Taylor had 17 when these two teams met a year ago. He's got 4 tonight, and it's a 28-19 Wichita State lead. Add to that lead with the triple.
Well, Marcus McDuffie has knocked down 2 three balls now, and Wichita State, when they hit shots like that, as bad as they are defensively, and I mean bad in a good way, it can just get nasty for somebody.
7-for-14 for Wichita State from beyond the arc. Loveridge, second leading scorer for the Utes, still no field goals.
Suffocating defense by Wichita State. The victim is Loveridge right now.
And an offensive foul that time. Fred VanVleet loves initiating contact that time. Good position by the Utes.
Marcus McDuffie, only a freshman, comes out of a tough neighborhood in Paterson, New Jersey. St. Anthony High School. That's how they do it in Jersey.
Constipated?
Thank you, Doug. Looking forward to that. Wichita State opening up a 31-19 lead on the 25-ranked Utah Running Utes with 3:19 to go. Next Saturday, the Utes will be in action against the Cameron Crazies in a rematch of last year's Sweet 16 matchup. That's Coach K and the 8th-ranked Dukies hosting the 25th-ranked Utes on ESPN.
I could make a real strong case for Jakob Pirtle and Grayson Allen being two of the most improved players in the country this year. Those guys have both improved their scoring by double digits over a season ago.
Alongside Mark Adams, I'm Rich Hollenberg. Wichita State looking to bounce back from losing 4 of their first 6 and regain the swagger that had them ranked in the top 10 at the start of this season. So far, so good for the Shockers.
They started getting it back against UNLV, and defensively, they just strangle-held that team, held them to 50 points. That's how Wichita State gets their swagger back. They defend, they go rebound it, they get loose balls, they play angry and beat you angry.
Fran Camp still looking for his first field goal as a Shocker.
He forced that one. That's a bad shot.
A combined 0-for-7 now for Connor Fran Camp. Maybe pressing just a little bit. Dribble handoff, Taylor blocked from behind by Baker.
Baker, one of the best shot-blocking guards in the country. Last season, he led the team in that category. A good defense by Utah, really taking the dribble away.
Seven to shoot. Baker posting up on the smaller Taylor. He gets it back with two. Frankamp alone. No. Offensive rebound, Rashard Kelly. Largest lead of the game for Wichita State.
Well, Rashard Kelly, that's exactly what Greg Marshall wanted to see out of Rashard Kelly, to make something happen.
An 8-2 Shockers run has opened up the largest lead of the game.
Boy, Pirtle just not able to get a lot of quality touches. Credit the footwork defense of Wichita State inside.
Bonham, left hand. No, Pirtle can't get the rebound. Kuzma does, wild shot, and it's rebounded by Wamakota.
Well, Utah just out of sync offensively.
1 minute to go in the half.
And we are without Van Vliet in half-court sets again. And Wichita State's offense has bogged down late in shot clocks.
Kelly dribbled it away. Got back by Frankamp.
Another ugly possession in the half-court set.
Frankamp still has not found the bottom of the bucket. And a Wichita State foul is going to go on number 32, Marcus McDuffie. Well, tonight it's the Heisman Trophy presentation in New York City. Is it going to be Derrick Henry, Christian McCaffrey, or Clemson QB Deshaun Watson? Those are the three finalists. The Heisman Trophy presented by Nissan Saturday. That's tonight at 8 Eastern on ESPN. Also streaming live on Watch ESPN. Now, you don't have a vote, an official vote, but who are you giving it to?
Christian McCaffrey, because he beat my Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Hats off to the number one guy in all-purpose yards in the history of college football. Who was number one before that? Some guy named Barry Sanders. That's pretty tall cotton right there.
The year Sanders broke that single-season record, 1988, he won the Heisman Trophy. So there's a vote in your corner
there you go,
for Christian McCaffrey. Here's Jakob Pirtle. We talked to Larry Krystowiak before the game, Mark. He said, our offensive game plan is simple. Get number 42 the ball, and yet they haven't been able to do that. Why not?
You know, first of all, the defense for Wichita State has been designed to take that away. But I think Jakob Pirtle's got to work harder. He's got to get lower. One thing Larry Krystowiak does a great job of teaching big guys is how to get the low center of gravity. I think he's playing a little bit too high right now. I think he's got to get lower and more active against this good, tough Wichita State defense.
Yeah, what does Coach K call it? Pad level?
Pad
it's like
level.
Football.
Got to get pad level. Yep. The low man wins, even on the block. It's not how tall you are. It's how low you leverage yourself.
Pirtle, 1-for-2 from the free throw line. That's an area he's really improved upon, going from 44% as a freshman to 67% this year.
Now he wants to get contact. He sees the free shots involved.
Last shot time for the Shockers. 10 seconds to go in the half.
Just watch Van Vliet, number 23, the closer.
Brown. It would have counted if it went, but it didn't. And we will go to halftime with Wichita State up 33-20, their largest lead of the game, and they've done it beyond the arc.
Three-pointers, 7-for-16, but look at the turnovers. One turnover for Wichita State, 12 turnovers, and the points off turnovers, the difference.
So our halftime score, Wichita State 33, the Running Utes of Utah 20. Stay tuned for the Land Rover Halftime Report coming up right now with Doug Kazarian and Jeff Goodman.
All right, fellas, thank you very much.
Amazing what Fred Van Vliet does as pressure from the point of attack. That's where it starts. When other four defenders see your point guard can pressure and rule that position, man, it brings energy to everybody else.
Utah came in averaging 82 points a game. They've been held to a quarter of that.
I would be willing to bet my house that Pirtle's going to get a touch on this possession. Somehow, some way, they've got to get him the basketball.
Loveridge Taylor, seven on the shot clock. They're going to have to hurry. Here's a pick and pop. Hurdle gets it with two on the shot clock, and he converts.
Thank God I get to keep my house. I was worried there in the last 2 seconds of the shot clock. But that's how good he is. Have a little bit of patience getting the ball.
One All-American and another.
He started the first half the same way, shooting it over the seven-footer, and now opens the second half the same way in a mid-range jump shot.
Fred VanVleet has 5 points, 2 for 5 from the field. Pirtle ducks his head down and gets the foul. Aggressive, Jakob Pirtle.
This is the difference with Jakob Pirtle. He's moving without the basketball. He's creating, look at him step in right there, creating angles for himself. A more aggressive on-ball screen, the roll down low, the pin. He's sitting down. He's balanced, takes it off the glass. That's the difference between the first half Jakob Pirtle and the second half Jakob Pirtle. We might have a basketball game now.
Pirtle makes the first. He now has 8 points. Coach once told me, if your big man has 1 foot in the paint, you should get him the ball. If he has 2 feet, you must get him the ball.
Especially if they're wide 2 feet, where he's sitting down, begging for the basketball.
Ball hits the floor as Ron Baker hits the deck as well. And it'll be Wichita State basketball. Foul's going to go on 21 in red, Jordan Loveridge. Well, you're looking right now at 31 in yellow and 23 in yellow. Fred VanVleet, Ron Baker, arguably the best backcourt in basketball when they're healthy.
And there's some guys that would rival that with as some of the best duos in the country in the backcourt. Brian Sullivan and Jack Gibbs at Davidson, two guys that really produce. I like those guys. Of course, Noah Trimble and Maryland, they got a pretty good 1-2 punch as well. If you shoot Schumann.
Brown lost the handle. And they say it's over the backboard, and it'll be Utah basketball. They need some offense from that young man, too, Kyle Kuzma, the sophomore, number 35 in red. He only has 2 points, no field goals this afternoon.
But if Utah runs inside out through Pirtle, other guys will get open because Wichita State is so focused on Jakob Pirtle. Look at all the gold jerseys that surround him. Get in the ball now. Give it to him. There it is.
He gets it, but he's pushed out along the baseline. He wants it again. Three ball, good inside-out offense for Utah.
Absolutely right, Rich. You know your hoops, man. They got the ball inside the Pirtle, which forced defenders to expand and contract. That's how you beat Wichita State or any good defense.
Wessel, he hit a couple of those in the first half. Missed that one.
Let's see if they play inside out again on this possession. That's Utah basketball. Grind it inside. There he is.
Pirtle. No.
Off balance.
Yeah,
a little bit too hot.
Might have gotten away with a little push in the back. A mismatch. VanVleet couldn't take advantage. And we've got a foul on the floor, 17:03 to go. So who would you compare these preseason All-Americas to, Mark?
New school, Andrew Bogut, although I think Bogut's a better passer than Pirtle. Old school, Kevin McHale, because of the way that he runs and his developing footwork. Old school for VanVleet, Darren Williams, a smaller Darren Williams because he's so physical. Old school, I'd go with John Stockton because of his ability to get to the rim. And for Ron Baker, Kurt Heinrich, who he models his game after, and I think Jeff Hornacek would be old school.
Here's Taylor. He has struggled mightily, not just in this game, but all season offensively. But Pirtle with the rebound and the putback. That's a 6-0 Utah run. They're right back in this game.
And the left hand by Pirtle. That's why I like him. He used to be pretty much all right-handed. Now he can go lefty as well.
10 points, 7 rebounds for number 42 in red, Jakob Pirtle.
Pirtle now matched up with VanVleet to trying to rotate through it.
Wessel goes right at Pirtle. And the conversion by Zach Brown, who's got 9.
I like Utah's defense that last possession, though. Wichita stayed a little bit lucky on that possession.
Taylor is 9 for 43 from three-point range this year, Mark. Here he is with the pull-up in two-point range, and he knocks it down.
Looked pretty good from two right there.
Yeah. Maybe you should stick to that. A couple feet in, nothing but net.
Holy cow.
Van Vliet with the blow-by in the left hand.
Where was Taylor? And that was just so quick, so efficient with the crossover. And Larry Kostolyak doesn't like that at all. That was unacceptable defense for Utah.
15:34 to go. Utah trailing by 9.
Evan Wessel with the shot and the tip right there. There's multiple hands up top. Watch this. Hello. Goodbye. Fred Van Vliet. Lay it up.
ESPN Films presents Four Falls Above.
Wichita State looking for the upset on 25th-ranked Utah. They lead by 9, 15:34 to go in the contest. Tonight after 30 for 30, the Four Falls of Buffalo. Stick around for SportsCenter at Night with Jay Harris and Kevin Connors. The guys recap the Heisman Trophy presentation. They'll have highlights from that terrific Army-Navy game going on. College hoops, NBA, the NHL, all of it at SportsCenter at Night after 30 for 30 on ESPN.
How great were the signs at the Army-Navy game for game day today? My favorite was Navy hates puppies.
Yeah.
From one of the cadets.
And
at West
some
Point.
Of the others we can't repeat on the air.
But they, you know, you get a, well, maybe you can.
Taylor. Loveridge drew the contact and the foul on the three-point shot. We have a TV timeout on the floor. That's foul going to go on Zach Brown and Utah shooting when we come back.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Buick, proud partner of the NCAA.
Holidays heating up?
I feel really warm.
Wichita State up 39-30 on Utah. Jordan Loveridge will be shooting three free throws, Mark Adams. Was that the right call by the officials?
It was the right call. Watch number 21, Jordan Loveridge, as the defender goes by. Okay, sticks out his right elbow. Now, if he would have moved to his left to draw contact, watch this. If he moves to his left, it's not a foul. But he goes straight up right there and gets caught on his right elbow and draws the three-point shot. If that was a situation where he moved left, it'd be more of a non-call.
Loveridge, just his third point of the afternoon. He still has zero field goals. This is a kid who's averaging 16 points a game coming in.
Yeah, he's a catch and shoot guy, and he has not been given the opportunity to catch and shoot.
That's right.
A lot of times because Evan Wessel is Greg Marshall's guy to defend in that situation.
Jordan Loveridge, number one in the Pac-12 in three-point field goals made per game. He hasn't even made a two-point so far today, but he has 5 points, and it's a two-possession ball game, 39-33, Shockers.
I like what Wichita has done in the second half. They've been a lot more aggressive, getting the ball to Pirtle. They've gotten better spacing offensively, and they've been much stingier defensively. Baker having a tough time getting a touch. He finally gets one in the mid-range game.
Five on the shot clock. Now it's on Van Vliet. He launches off the mark. Scramble for the ball. They're going to get the foul on Evan Wessel. More often than not, Evan Wessel gets the better of those contact duos, but not that time.
Yeah, but he... Watch Evan Wessel as the ball goes up. Good block off here by Taylor. He just goes right over the back. I mean, Evan Wessel's as good as anybody of mixing it up and going getting loose balls. I call him the Labrador because he retrieves everything. He's loyal and he retrieves everything. The Labrador, Evan Wessel.
Unconditional love for Evan Wessel. Isn't that what you say about Labradors?
Absolutely. I've got one.
Chapman, nice feed inside. Loveridge still No field goals for Jordan Loveridge, but the aggressive play on offense will send him to the free throw line.
But what you like about that is Loveridge, known as a three-point guy, and of course he's been defended well and denied well in the three-point line. So they decide, okay, if you're gonna take that away, we're gonna take 6'6", 220 pounds, we're gonna post him up on the block and get him the ball. I like the way Larry Krystowiak really brings that NBA mentality offensively, where if there's a mismatch, it's exposed. If there's a player that's not in a rhythm, how do you get them in rhythm and you run a specific play to get them involved? That's smart coaching.
Loveridge, a 79% free throw shooter coming in, is perfect from the field or from the free throw line. And we now have our closest score since it was 13-9 earlier in the first half. Nice feed inside, Baker to Morris.
Hurdle not in a stance, wasn't ready to defend, and was an easy pick on that play.
First two of the afternoon for Shaq Morris. Bottom. Met at the rim by Morris. And blocked on the other end by Chapman.
What, did Chapman sprint back and make a play? That was a big play.
All of a sudden, it looks like two of the better defensive teams in the country, which we would come to expect from these two clubs.
This could be a huge swing in this game if Utah can score.
Hurdle tried to back down and instead stumbled over his own feet for another turnover.
Look at defenders reacting. Shaq Morris coming from the backside as the second defender with the big block. And then Chapman just sprints back in the left hand. Most of your great shot blockers are left-handed. And man, Chapman just sprinted and got there.
Why are most of the best shot blockers lefties?
Because right-hand shooters, they mirror each other. When right-handers go up, you got a left hand right in their grill. That's how you block shots. David Robinson, one of the great shot blockers in NCAA history, left-handed. Keith Kloss, who played for me, the greatest shot blocker in NCAA history by average. Left-handed and 7'3" wingspan wasn't bad either.
That's Utah's second team foul. 13-18 to go. Wichita State looking to win their third straight game after dropping four of their first six.
Look at the denial of Ron Baker. He finally gets a touch right there. Brandon Taylor matched up, and now they switch off.
Here's the freshman, McDuffie. Yes! And the foul! Third three-pointer of the day for Marcus McDuffie, and he's a chance to add to it.
Marcus McDuffie, remember that name. He will be the next star at Wichita State. Balanced size. The fish hook goodbye, Marcus McDuffie.
Huge recruit for Greg Marshall to come from a heralded program like Bob Hurley's at St. Anthony's in New Jersey.
And nothing but winners come out of St. Anthony.
The steal, but they're going to call Baker for the foul. And look at Greg Marshall applauding the effort. Ron Baker just picked his pocket in the backcourt, but was whistled for the foul.
Well, you sense that Wichita State understands the opportunity against the number 25 team in the country. Last year, they were number 8. They were the team being hunted. This afternoon, in Wichita, they are the hunter.
Five on the shot clock. Here's Isaiah Wright.
Tough. Man, that's confidence right there by Isaiah Wright. He only averages just over 1 point per game. Willing to take and make that big shot.
And the foul's going to go on 20 in red, Chris Reyes. It's his third foul. Let's take a look at the previous play.
Jordan Loveridge really wanted the ball on the backside. Look, you see his shoes on the backside, and he was open, but Isaiah Wright decides, hey, I can make this mid-range shot. That shows guts right there from a guy that typically doesn't score a whole lot.
That's only the third three-pointer for Utah in this game. Credit the Shockers' defense.
Baker's got a size mismatch. He's going to use it over Taylor.
Short. Good hustle by Morris, but Utah still clears. Utah at 7-1, their first true road game of the season. And even though the Shockers aren't ranked right now, this would go down as a signature win for Utah.
You know, this is the first road game for Utah this season. It took them about a half to realize they're in a hostile environment in Wichita.
Taylor, crossover. One more to Loveridge. Here's Baker on the leak out. Van Vliet drew the contact. They wave it off, and they're going the other way. Second foul on Fred Van Vliet, and Greg Marshall can't believe it. Well, Mark, Wichita State has lived and thrived by the three-pointer this afternoon.
And Marcus McDuffie right there out of St. Anthony High School strokes it. Marcus McDuffie, yeah, get up!
Doug Kazarian with a studio update over on ESPN. Kentucky hosting Arizona State. Cats were up just one at the break. Derek Willis rattles home the three. Wildcats in control about 8.5 minutes to go again over on ESPN. Meanwhile, Maryland in control at home, looking to remain undefeated at home, up 11 approaching halftime. Let's go back out to Wichita with Mark and Rich.
Thank you, Doug. Wichita State up 45-38 on the 25th ranked run in Utes, 11:38 to go. And when you talk about Wichita State, nobody calls them a mid-major anymore. They are rivaling the blue blood programs in terms of success over the last few years.
No question, and we've watched that take place as we look at the average win per season over the last five seasons. Even Kansas doesn't have a better record. And oh, by the way, that was Wichita State that beat Kansas last year in the NCAA tournament. When you talk about Greg Marshall and what he has done versus the legends of the game over a 17-year period, he really comes up well against both Mike Krzyzewski and Jim Boeheim.
Third best winning percentage since 2010-11. Only Duke and Gonzaga have a better winning percentage than Wichita State. Pirtle with the touch. The double team comes, and it's off Jakob Pirtle.
Pirtle's being double teamed at different times. That time, Van Vliet decoyed him, kind of juked away. And watch, as soon as he puts the ball on the floor, this is the game plan right here. He catches, look at Van Vliet. And then he's going to put it on the floor. And what does Van Vliet do? Then he attacks the dribble. That's not by coincidence. That's game planned.
14 Utah turnovers compared to just two for Wichita State. Connor Frankamp, 33 in yellow, back in for the Shockers. And boy, would the Shocker faithful love to see him knock down a field goal.
Yeah, if he can get free, 33 in gold, he's open too.
Here's Duffy. He's open as well.
And he's good.
4 3-pointers for the freshman.
Look at McDuffie. Just long. He's trying to get the deflections, bringing energy. Welcome to the national conscience of college basketball, Marcus McDuffie.
No, McDuffie clears. Van Vliet. Here's Brown. Back out to Fred. Under 10 minutes to go, 10 on the shot clock.
If McDuffie gets open, Fred Van Vliet will give him the ball again.
Feeds Wamakota. Another assist for Van Vliet. Another chance at a three-point play for Wichita.
Fred Van Vliet matched up with Pirtle, decides to put it on the floor, and he reads the defender coming from the block. That means that Bush Wamakota is wide open. Fred Van Vliet sees everything.
Fred Van Vliet has 7 points, 5 assists, 3 rebounds. his preseason All-America backcourt mate, Ron Baker, 7 points, 5 assists, 4 rebounds. This team will go as far as those two will take them.
Yeah, and that could be all the way to the Final Four.
Out of bounds. Oh, and they say it's Utah ball. Greg Marshall's got to be careful. It's right in front of the Wichita bench, but I might have to agree with him on this one.
Greg Marshall's going to have a little discussion with the official right here, talking about he saw it. He might have had the best angle in the building.
It's been an 11-3 Wichita State run over the last minute and a half to regain a stranglehold on this game.
Well, this scrambling defense, Wichita State has turned up the pressure defensively.
Taylor, contested three, no. Here's Van Vliet. For three, short. Taylor wants to push. Kuzma, no, he rushed the shot. And Krystowiak is on the floor screaming at the officials. And we'll have to check. It looks like he got teed up.
Yeah, he came out because of the shot block he thought was defensive basket interference. And he exploded off the bench. Watch this now. Ball goes up. Is it underneath the rim? Watch.
I think that was clean.
I think it was clean, too.
Watch the ball.
Well, hard to tell.
Yeah.
Hard to tell. But Larry Krystowiak also had maybe a similar angle to what Greg Marshall had on the opposite end, and he didn't like that non-call at all. I recruited Larry Krystowiak out of high school, tried to get him when I was at Idaho State. He's one of the most fiery competitors that you're ever going to see. This is a guy that went to Montana, became the most dominant big guy in the Big Sky, and parlayed that into an NBA career from Montana. That dude competes.
Here's Frankamp, and his struggles continue. His only points in his first game against UNLV came via the free throw line. A couple of clutch ones with about a minute left in the game to ice that one away against the running Rebels. He misses his first one here and misses that one as well.
That's a mental thing then. He's missed enough shots and it has grown on him. But Larry Krystowiak, let's see how the Utes, how they respond now after this timeout. He's a fiery competitor. I love it.
It's really interesting talking to Larry Krystowiak. He takes his coaching cues from two legends, Jerry Sloan and Phil Jackson.
Yeah.
He's got a little bit of both in him.
And Mike Montgomery as well, who he played for at Montana. Of course, Mike, the former head coach at Montana and Stanford and Cal.
Kelly, no. Plenty of time for the running Utes to get back in this game.
So Pirtle really wants it. They're going to get it to him. Good pass.
Right. Ten on the shot clock. Good hands by Wichita State, and it's another Utah turnover. 15th turnover forced by the Shockers D.
When after that technical foul, the last thing you want is a turnover on the next offensive possession. But that's exactly what happened to Utah.
Here's Frankamp. Foul's going to go on Jakob Poeltl. That's his second.
Well, Utah, number 25 in the country, their first road game. They beat BYU, really played well against BYU. And when you go to Salt Lake, great college basketball fans in Salt Lake City. I used to love going there when I coached out west. Of course, Rick Majerus, one of the great coaches in college basketball history. Now, Larry Krystowiak has brought this Utah program back in the Pac-12. A lot of people didn't think they could make that jump. They've not only made that jump, they're a contender right now. Oh, Sean Miller's bunch of Arizona.
One for one, he's in double digits with 10 points. And listen to this crowd, it's going to stay Wichita State ball. And Van Vliet, after a quick breather, checks back in. Pirtle will go to the bench, and Chris Reyes will take his spot.
One of our old Missouri Valley buddies, Konzo Martin, also doing the job at Cal. Great recruiting class. Taylor versus Baker matchup. I wonder why they don't put him in the mid-range game and just shoot over. He's got a size advantage.
And Fleet hangs and hits. He has 9, and it's an 8-0 Shockers run.
Hurdle wasn't there. And Van Vliet wrecked.
Large 38.
And just look how stingy this is. They're just nothing easy.
Seven-12 to go. Wichita State trying to step on the throats of the 25th-ranked Utes.
Fred Van Vliet sees the advantage and takes advantage.
Largest lead of the game for the Shockers in front of their home crowd, 53-38 over the 25th-ranked Utes, 7-12 to go. And Marcus McDuffie has stepped up as the third complimentary scorer for the Shockers club.
Marcus McDuffie is the next star at Wichita State. We saw Ron Baker. We saw Fred Van Vliet as freshman. Heck, I even remember guys like Xavier McDaniel and Cheese Johnson as freshmen. This kid is going to be really, really good and is the next guy in line at Wichita State.
Four for five from three-point range. He has been leading the charge for a Shockers team that came in shooting just 30% from beyond the arc. But this afternoon, when you talk about hot shooting, they're 43% from three-point range.
You knew they had it in them. And listen, Utah has shown throughout the season so far, they're not a good defensive team from beyond the arc. And Wichita State, Ron Baker, can make them. Fred Van Vliet can make him. Evan Wessel made some today, and Marcus McDuffie's been huge.
Loveridge at the line where he's earned all of his points this afternoon. That's been another one of the litany of problems for the run in Utes today against Wichita State. And when you talk to Larry Krystowiak before the game, he said that week off in between games, they had 7 days off before this game. And he said, we got better defensively, but our Achilles heel is guarding the ball, and that's shown up today.
Oh, and he also said that Pirtle, Kuzma, and Loveridge have to come up big for them to win on the road. And that just has not happened.
9 points for Loveridge. That leads the Utes, other than Pirtle, who has 10. The problem is all of Loveridge's points have come from the free throw line.
Which, by the way, Utah does a great job of getting to the line. They've made more free throws on the season than other teams have attempted against them.
Brown has 11. And alongside Marcus McDuffie, the sophomore Zach Brown, 6'6", 216-pounder out of Houston, has really started to emerge. It takes a lot to get Greg Marshall to highly praise one of his young players, but he did that today. He said Zach Brown is coming along really nicely for him.
The first 5 games, Zach Brown was 4 for 17. The last 3 games going into today, 10 for 18. That's the big leap that he's made offensively. He's at a comfort level now.
His career high is 14 is Zach Brown. He's got 12 today. A 15-point Shockers lead. Five on the shot clock. Taylor, nice take.
Really good take. Took Fred VanVleet right to the rim right there. He had 17 in that win in Salt Lake City. He's a guy that can lead the way as well.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Wessel. Brown, wild shot, gets it to drop. Zach Brown has matched his career high. He has 14.
Zach Brown and Marcus McDuffie. We came in, we expected Van Vliet. We expected Ron Baker to play well. Those two guys have come up huge. That's why this team is dangerous come March.
Taylor. Van Vliet got a hand on it. Pirtle the rebound. Jump ball. And it's going to stay Wichita State basketball. Pirtle with his 8th rebound of the game.
Zach Brown was the most improved player on Wichita State last season. He takes the bump right there, but stays balanced and knocks it down. Zach Brown emerging now in their half-court sets. This team is 4-4. That's an anomaly. This team's a top 10 team.
Wessel, camped out, can't hit.
That's halfway down.
Good defense by Baker to shut down Loveridge.
And Loveridge not forcing though. It's showing some maturity on offense. Turnover again for Utah.
16 turnovers for Utah, and that has been their Achilles heel today. Not guarding the basketball. They just haven't taken care of the basketball.
22-0 points off turnovers. That pretty much takes care of it, doesn't it?
Spin move. Morris. No.
Good defense by Pirtle. Really moved his feet. He built the fence around the basket.
Here's Pirtle, and they're going to get the touch foul on Shaq Morris. That's the third on 24 in yellow, Shaq Morris.
I really like how Pirtle can go to that mid-range area, catch the ball, and then make a move. It really puts defenders in a situation like Shaq Morris where he had to reach out and grab him to stop him. That's why I made that McHale. As I look at what Jakob Pirtle could become, that comparison with McHale, because McHale loved that dead space right around 12 feet and could make plays and make moves.
11 points for Pirtle to go along with 8 rebounds. He already has 5 double-doubles this season. Staring straight in the eyes at number 6. Another 1-for-2 trip from the free throw line for Jakob Pirtle.
He shot 44% last year, 66% going into the game this year. A lot more aggressive trying to get to the line, Jakob Pirtle.
Wessel. He hit his first three-pointer and hasn't hit one since.
There's the Labrador Retriever.
Here he is again. No.
And he gets his hands on another one in order to get another possession. Okay, so he misses 2 shots, big deal. He gets you 2 more possessions.
And Mark, this is why Wichita State is some of the smartest, best fans in college basketball. They applauded that offensive rebound. And then Nurser adds it. ...26 points in the paint for the Shockers. And they've blown this one open. And timeout, Utah. Well, it's not Coke Arena with a sold-out crowd of 10,000. It's Intrust and a sold-out crowd of 15,000. Largest lead of the game for Wichita State, 59-43. And when you talk about playing angry, Greg Marshall has indoctrinated this club that hustle points are where you're going to win your ball games.
So you miss a shot, Evan Wessel. Big deal. The Labrador goes and retrieves it. So you miss a shot, Evan Wessel. I'm going to throw you a stick. Go get it, Labrador. as he tips it inside to Nurzier. Gives him an extra opportunity to score. That's what Evan Wessel does. He just wins at a 90% clip in his collegiate career.
87-9 in his Wichita State career. He is the most successful senior in the country. And he's shown the ability to hit the three-pointer. He hit two in the first half. He's just gone cold from the field in the second half. And yet, it's his hustle and his heart and his ability to play angry that really is the embodiment of the Shockers team.
In high school football, basketball, and collegiate basketball combined, Evan Wessel is 181-13.
Here's a little recap of what's gone on today. 25th-ranked Utah came in saying, we have got to get Jakob Poeltl the ball. He's had a nice game, but he certainly hasn't dominated. 10 points, 8 rebounds. The problem for Wichita State, or the problem for Utah, I should say, is they have turned the ball over 16 times, and Wichita State's made a pay virtually every time.
Yeah, and Zach Brown and Marcus McDuffie have been the other two really good players for Wichita State above and beyond their All-American backcourt in Fred VanVleet and Ron Baker.
Well, 3:33 to go. It's now or never for Larry Krystowiak's club. They try to get it to Poeltl and it's off his fingertips. Turnover number 17.
When all Larry Krystowiak can do is basically sit down and just glare at the store, at the scoreboard. He is not happy at all, and he shouldn't be.
So keep in mind, next week, they go to New York City to take on the Blue Devils.
Of course, they lost in the Sweet 16 to Duke last season in the NCAA tournament. Nice rematch.
Five on the shot clock. VanVleet floats, doesn't hit. Poeltl with his ninth board.
Well, Utah certainly has played much better this season. They've shown in this game, but the turnovers have just killed them every time.
That's number 20, and VanVleet will go to the line. 2:43 to go. At least there's a smile on Fred VanVleet's face when he hits the deck like that. Be a little gassed after that drive to the hoop and getting fouled hard. He misses his first free throw. How about this for a discrepancy, Mark Adams? Wichita State, 14 assists, only 2 turnovers. Utah has only 4 assists and 18 turnovers.
Utah has really struggled in their half-court sets to make good decisions. That's the one thing that this team's going to learn in a hurry, that they've made bad decisions. Credit Wichita State's defense, but Utah's made some bad decisions on the offensive end.
Might be the last we see of Fred VanVleet in today's game. It was team up 18. A block, and they call a foul on Baker. So VanVleet will probably call it an afternoon after notching his 10th point of the contest. He also has 6 assists, and he's stretching out that hamstring.
Yeah, and that's exactly why. They're going to be very careful with him with the hamstring injury that kept him out of 4 games earlier. I mean, how important is that young man to Wichita State? We're talking about his freshman year going to Final Four, 35-0 in his sophomore year. His junior year, they beat Kansas to go to the Sweet 16 in the NCAA tournament. And this year, they're losing for 4 games. They go 2-4. Open the season.
All he has is 98 career wins. And if things go the way that Greg Marshall hopes and expects for them to go, he'll end up being the all-time winningest shot.
Yeah. Of course, the Missouri Valley has the win over North Carolina by Northern Iowa, and now Wichita State has number 25 Utah on the ropes. Both played at Valley Arenas, by the way. That's very unusual.
Nurzier. Point game. 2 minutes left.
Is it fair to say that if Wichita State can hold on here, that they're the best 5-4 team in America?
It'll be interesting to see if the AP voters give them enough votes to get into the top 25.
Now, I don't think they will. I think if they were Michigan State or Duke in the same situation, I think those teams would get in the top 25. And that's not right, but that's just reality.
Under a minute and a half to go.
UNLV knocked off Oregon. Couldn't win at Wichita State. Utah comes in as number 25. And Wichita State, frankly, has handled them.
Last year, this game went down to the wire, and Utah won it in overtime by one. Today, nowhere near the drama. It's been all shockers. Here's Frankamp. Got it! Listen to the crowd. There's an answer three from Utah. The local boy, Connor Frankamp, out of North High School in Wichita, Kansas, has his first field goal as a Wichita State Shocker.
Frankamp made two big free throws late game against UNLV while he went 0 for 5 from the floor and was 0 for today as well until that shot. The hometown kid. They've been waiting for this since he transferred a year ago from Kansas.
And that was a jump shot that he didn't even have a chance to think about because the shot clock was running down. Maybe that's just what the doctor ordered.
That's exactly what he needed. Stop thinking and just start reacting and playing.
Now J.R. Simon, the walk-on, is on to clean things up for the Shockers. But it has been a clean game all around. They protected the basketball, they shared the basketball, and they scored the basketball.
Here we go. Welcome to a new era of Wichita State basketball. They love him.
Wichita State now has a 36-game home winning streak, second in the nation. And message sent to the rest of the country, the Shockers, if not all the way back, they are almost there. A convincing win against the 25th-ranked Utah Running Utes. Your final score, Wichita State 67 and Utah 50. The Shockers back above 500 at 5-4, and Utah drops to 7-2 on the season. For my broadcast partner, Mark Adams, I'm Rich Hollenberg. That'll do it for us. Now let's go back to the studio. Doug Kazarian and Jeff Goodman. Shockers, winners on their home floor by 17.